Ladies and gentlemen, this is Joe's Video Games, back with another really cool arcade game that we just got in, and we figured we'd take a little video of for all of our YouTube fans. You can see all of the arcade games that we have for sale here at the shop on our website. You can go to lionsarcade.com and see pictures and prices and descriptions of all the stuff we have in currently. By the time you see this video, we may no longer have this game. We're filming this in July of 2015, but who knows when you're watching this. So this is Cinematronics World Series The Season arcade game. It's a kind of unique game that a lot of people remember from back in the day because of the unique controls. So we figured we'd shoot a little video since we got this one in, so you guys could remember what once was. So Cinematronics started out making, and a lot of these companies sold to different owners and things, so things changed, but they started out making Pong type games, like, you know, Atari Pong clone games, which a lot of companies did for a while, and then moved into making vector games like Solar Quest and Star Castle, things like that. And then after that, moved into making Laserdisc games like Dragon's Lair, which everybody's played, and Dragon's Lair 2. And then after that, moved into making these games that they referred to as the Cinemat system, which was kind of a, whenever they were making all their vector games like Star Castle, they kind of used the same board over and over and over again with just different ROMs on it and a different soundboard. And this is kind of a similar idea. They used, you know, they were trying to do the same thing kind of with their Laserdisc games. If I'm sure if that would have worked out a little better, they would have made 15 different Laserdisc games where you just needed a different ROM set on the game board and a different Laserdisc. But this was kind of a continuation of that. It's a little, it's got a little motherboard in there and a little ROM board, and they made several different games. They had a bowling one called Up Your Alley that was similar to this. They had four or five of these baseball games like this, and they had Ivan Stewart's Off-Road awesome game that used a similar board set. I don't think you can just swap those boards or just swap the ROMs to make them new games, but if you pull the that board out and look at the board in this, they're real similar. It's the same kind of design. So the side art on this one's been about half ripped off. We couldn't think of anything to do to fix it, so we just left it. But you can't really get that replacement side art for that. Had the really cool control panel with the cool controls. We'll get back to that here in a second. There is the marquee. Then the side art on this side is the same. It's a little more complete. Still has a few spots where kids peeled it off. These cabinets were always kind of rough, and my brother here has been suggesting that it's because there was no leg levelers on it from the factory. Most games have little, if you look at Turbo here, see how it's off the ground just a little bit? That's because there's little feet under there. And this game, they didn't put feet on it from the factory, so we installed some and got it off the ground a little bit, but they're always in kind of rough shape. So anyway, it was a typical baseball game, but it had a battery on the game board that could save all of your statistics. So you could put like a code in and put your initials in, and it would save all of your info. On the front of the game, it had this little place for stat keys. And there's a little, that one's got a chunk of wood in it or something, or a piece of gum or something, but there's a little slot where you could slide a little card in it on those pins to save your stuff, like a little memory card. I've never seen anybody that had one, but they did exist at one point. So there were different ones. The first one was just called World Series. This one was called World Series The Season. There was another one called World Series 2, I believe. There was one called Double Play Home Run Derby, where you just shot for home runs, because on this game it was kind of easy to get a home run. And then there was a strike zone, which was more pitching based. So, but on this one, you could play two players at the same time.
And it would go back, it would alternate in innings. You know, you would bat on one inning and pitch on the other inning. So if two people were playing, you would take turns going back and forth, which is pretty cool. Oh, John Elway's quarterback. That's another one that they made. Okay, so we'll read the instructions. So if you're batting, batter, pull back on bat until the batter is in set position. Pull further for increased power. So, of course, you always pulled it all the way back. And they had these interesting little bat joysticks, they called them, where it has a spring inside of there, so it always goes back to where it goes whenever you let go of it. And so you had some control where you could basically, since you're batting, if you went up or down, it raised on the screen where your bat was going to hit in the strike zone. So you had some control over that, but you didn't know what the pitcher was going to throw, you know, just like a real game. Raise or lower bat for proper swing height. Release bat to swing. Press extra base button to try for extra bases. That doesn't say steal bases, it just means extra base. So if you're running, you can hit that button to try to go another base. Use the go back button if the runner is less than halfway. So if you're trying to get to the second base and, you know, it looks like they're going to be able to throw it in, you can hit go back and go back. And there's, you see how the batter was on the left, the pitcher was on the right. There was a split screen thing while you were playing. I'll shoot a little video showing the gameplay here in a minute. All right, pitcher. When a new aim is desired, press and hold the aim button and position the white dot with the joystick. Release the aim button. So there's two aim buttons. Either one of them does the same thing. So basically you hit that button, and then on the screen there's a little white dot. And you can see the catcher with his mitt up, and you move this around until you get the white dot where you want it. And then once you let go of the aim button, that dot stays there, and that's where you're throwing the ball each time. Pull back joystick to desired pitch and speed. Pitcher must come to set before he will pitch. Release joystick. So you've got some control over what kind of ball he throws towards that white dot that you've set. So you can make it break right, you can make it break left, you can throw it slow, or you can throw it fast, depending on where you position this little thing. But once you get it where you want it, you let go of it, and it throws the ball. So to throw a fastball, you just pull it straight back. That's as fast as you're going to be able to throw it. So that's a pretty cool little game. You had a lot of control over the bat, which was neat. Cinematronics World Series, the season. If you played a lot of games back in the day, I'm sure you saw one of these, or you'll at least remember those little controls. They also made a kit to turn other games into this game. So you may have seen one that had these controls on the control panel, but the cabinet looked different. But this is a dedicated one. It was, if you bought the thing from the factory, it would have this cabinet with that game board and all the controls installed in it already. So there you are. I'll set up the tripod. We'll film a little video of the gameplay and go through how to bat and how to pitch. All right, so we're going to play through this a little bit. See if I can get the hang of the controls again. I probably haven't played this in 25 years, something like that, 20 years. Really cool game, though. It's baseball. How can you not like baseball, folks? It's baseball. America's pastime. All right, I'm going to add some credits to it, unless it's on free play. It is not on free play.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Very much.
Thank you very much.
Oh, all right. Notice it's set up for 32 innings because I put two credits on. Doubt we're going to play that many innings because you guys would all go to sleep on me, but we'll play a couple. I like how it tells you how far the walls are. 367, 410, 367. So we'll play one player. If you have a statistics key, enter it now. Initials and birthday are used for storing stats. If you do not want to store your stats, press the 1 or 2 player start button. So we'll do that. Press and hold the extra base button for stats.
press go back button for instructions. Press one or two player button to start to begin play. The reason that it says that is because if I would have put in my initials, it would have my stuff in there. You are pitching. Okay, here we go. So see the little white dot? You hit this aim, and then you figure out where you want to put it, and you let go of it. That's where he's going to throw. So now, no matter however you do your pitch, that's where the ball will end up.
Right.
So we'll aim it. Go a little inside on him. All right. We'll try it again, but we'll throw a slow one.
You're out.
Still got it, folks. All right, so let's throw one inside to scare him a little bit.
Out.
All right, and then let's throw one up by his head.
Ball.
Oh, come on. Now we'll throw it right down the middle, but slow.
Ball.
Maybe a little too slow.
Foul ball.
All right, now we're going to put it outside. There we go.
Ball.
A little too far outside.
Ball.
Oh, come on. You're kind of at the mercy of the computer whenever the, if they hit it.
Out.
There we go. All right, now I'm up at bat. Here we go. It's as easy as that, folks. But if you see the arrow is what you're controlling, and you just pull back and you just try to time it. I'm going out swinging, folks.
Out.
Now, come on.
Foul ball. Foul ball.
Uh-oh. Ruh-roh.
Out.
Good little hit. I could have hit the extra base button and he would have kept going, but I just wasn't thinking about it.
Foul ball. Foul ball.
Ah, come on.
Out.
All right, I'm pitching now. Only 31 more innings to go, though. I thought it was letting me go down earlier.
Out. Ball.
Went a little too slow that time. Slow enough that time he could hit it good. Throw it straight down the middle, see what he can do with it. Okay, folks, if you're playing this game, I just confirmed, don't throw it straight down the middle and see what he can do with it.
Out.
Let's try that again.
Ball.
I guess if it's slow, he can see that it's going to be a ball.
Ball.
I like if you look, you can see it coming at you over here too, so you can tell where I've where it ends up going. We'll throw it right at the ump's face.
Out.
All right. Oop, sorry. Woo! Oh man.
Out.
I was a little low. The mechanics of it are pretty good, depending on how you hit it. You know, it's pretty believable. Like if you're a little high when you hit the ball, it hits the ground. If you're a little low when you hit the ball, you get more of a pop fly, you know. Which, of course, all the new games are like that, but this thing was early. This is like 84, 85. I'm gonna try to throw a curve, like a strong curve.
Ball.
Oop. Let's try to put it right there in the mitt, though.
Ball.
It's still more of a fastball.
Out. Ball.
Bring it up a little bit. Oh, come on. He should have caught that. I think we need to trade that guy in the offseason.
Right.
It's a good little curveball, you know, like.
Out.
So they made one of these, like the third one was you only batted.
Right.
Oop, a little early there. And then the fourth one, you only pitched. So it's kind of, you know, just variations on the same thing.
Out.
Oh, come on. All their guys can catch anything.
Out.
But my guy missed that easy one. Got him with the old crossover.
Get out!
There you go. Get out of there, you sucker. Don't worry me.
Ball. Out.
All right. Yeah.
right over the second baseman's head.
Strike.
I want to at least get one home run. Come on now. There's no way. How come the animated red ones are better than the animated blue ones? Makes no sense, folks. Makes no sense.
Out.
My infielders are pretty good, though. We'll throw this one outside. We'll see if we can make it cross over again. Watch this.
Ball.
A little too much.
Strike.
One more time.
Ball.
Oop. So now we'll go right down the middle on them. Folks, don't go right down the middle on them. Don't do that. Finally, one of these guys earns their little computer paycheck.
Foul ball. Out.
Oh, come on. I was robbed.
Out.
I was robbed again. I'm a little low on all of them, so what's going on? Come on!
Inside
on him.
Ball. Foul ball. Ball.
Oh, he got it. He's figured me out. I would like to fire this sprite and that sprite. See what I'm saying? You see this? Look at that.
Ball. Out.
The infielders are awesome. Better than his infielders, my guy would have had that.
Out. Hey.
That must have heard me.
Out.
What is this? What is this nonsense?
Ball. Ball. Strike!
All right, we're going to do one more at bat.
Yeah.
Just so I can see if I can get a home run.
Foul ball.
We're going to do my little outside.
Ball.
Couldn't he have tagged the guy when he drove by? Well, I mean, come on now. He could have tagged that guy.
Foul ball.
Man, he just don't have the strength.
Out.
The strength of the... I wonder if the different little characters have different stats.
Out.
Out. Oh, well, there we go, folks. I tried. I just didn't have the skills. But you get the idea. You guys have probably all played this, guys and girls. Don't want to leave the ladies out. You guys and girls have probably all played this back in the day. So there you go, and that's World Series of the Season. By the time you see this video, we may not have Mr. World Series of the Season anymore. Maybe somebody's already picked it up. This is a pretty inexpensive game, so they sell kind of quickly sometimes. But maybe we got something else you're interested in. You can stop by our shop. We're in downtown Rock Hill, South Carolina, which is about 15 minutes south of Charlotte, North Carolina, and just see what we've got in stock. Or you can check out our website, lionsarcade.com. Look, they're showing me how to play it. They think I'm so weak that I don't even know how to play it. All right, so go to lionsarcade.com and you can see all the games that we have available. Or if not, just check us out here on YouTube. Subscribe to us. We're going to be putting up all kinds of different videos of different games. Just anything we get in that's interesting, we'll shoot a little video of it and show you what the gameplay is like and the artwork, just so you can remember how these things used to be. We will see you next video.